Hello, 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 good evening. Hello to all of you lovely people. Except the person who gave my announcement video a thumbs down, if you're here. I don't know why you would do that. I was just announcing the stream. I don't see why you have to be hostile about that. Hello to everyone in the chat room. We have CPC Gamer, Just Drop, Oxbow, Afferall, Kostya, and Melkadrian. Yeah, exactly. I was doing you guys a favor, and somebody gave that video a thumbs down. Not the one I just posted like 5 minutes ago, the one I posted yesterday. People always complain, you never announce the streams in advance. And when I do, and that's gratitude for you. Alright, I'm going to start off with a little Spelunky. I probably won't spend too much time on it. I'll just do a couple quick practice runs and then try out the daily challenge. The games I've been playing the most recently have been Nuclear Throne and Eldritch, which are really awesome. I can't wait to show them off. Is there a thumbs down on Facebook now? I know people kept like clamoring for them to add a dislike button to Facebook, but I don't know if that's really necessary. Facebook is already a negative enough place as it is. That's why I deleted my personal Facebook account. I only have my my Facebook page for, you know, stream announcement purposes and all that. I'm really out of practice with this game, by the way. I'm hoping I won't embarrass myself too badly. I didn't notice any YouTube announcements. Well, I posted, I used the live on YouTube thing. I don't actually stream on YouTube, because the one time I tried it, it was a pretty terrible experience. But I used that to announce the stream. And it's pretty cool, there's like a countdown timer and everything, so you know exactly when the stream will start. No matter what time zone you're in. Hello, Perigo. Or Perigot, I forget. It's been a while. I'm sorry. I know I do this every time, but I'm sorry it's been so long. I've just been busy, man. I know that's hard to believe. I mean, it is me, but stuff going on. However, I started my vacation today from work. I mean, technically, you know, it starts on Monday. That's the first day I scheduled off. But I have 16 days off in a row, counting the weekends. And I thought I would celebrate that with a little stream. And I dare say this hopefully won't be the only one during my vacation. I like it when these guys are right next to the exit. Makes my job easy. Hello, Lord Monkfishy. Duke will show us some new games on stream, and I will go check them out and get hooked. Well, that's the idea, Kostya. I like to spread the love. Are you finishing Potful Mill? Yes, I am. I don't know exactly how long it'll be. I know it won't be too much longer. I'm almost done with the game. I plan to knock that out sometime during my vacation. Climbing gloves, cape, not worth spending my money. I mean, it would be nice to have those things, but I don't have much money. I'd rather save what I have for possible better items in the future. So yeah, it's been a while, guys. get all my embarrassing deaths out of the way early. I should probably go this way and pick up that money. Pretty much anything on YouTube is dismal lately. I mean, YouTube has, Google, I should say, has made some pretty obnoxious decisions regarding YouTube lately. But the people I follow on YouTube are still, you know, that part's still good. I don't really like the whole linking YouTube with Google Plus thing, but on the plus side, it means you finally see Duke of the Bump under my videos instead of Mashirin. I wish they would just let me change my URL and just get rid of the Mashirin part completely, but I guess this is the best I'm going to get. Hello, Forever Man. Is your name Chakan? That's the only Forever Man that I know of. The beeping is on my end. Yeah, that's the sound that the chat window makes whenever someone says Duke. That's how I know, oh hey, someone's asking me a question directly. I should probably take a look at the chat window. Not that that means you should be annoying and spam Duke over and over again. Any of you? But you know, I always like taking questions in the chat room, so if any of you want to ask me anything, you know, that's probably the best way to do it. Moore's did an excellent Fatal Labyrinth LP. Yes, that was pretty cool. I like that game. You can't believe I knew about Chakan? What, a classic video game like that? Who doesn't know about it? That's a joke. Probably not many people are that familiar with Chakan. Luckily, I had a relative who had a Genesis, and he let me borrow all of his games, and Chakan was one of them. I never made it very far in that game. It was pretty hard. Supposedly, there was going to be a Chakan sequel for the Dreamcast. I saw, like, concept art for it or something a while back. That could have been cool. Wasn't that based on a comic book or something? I should look that up. Well, too late to go into the shop now. Unless I want to attempt to trigger that trap without getting hit. It was one of the coolest looking games on Sega, yeah. The game definitely looked pretty awesome. And it had a really cool atmosphere to it, like the music and the sound effects and everything. It's just when it came to actually playing the game that I took umbrage with it. Hello, Turdstream and Baron Creel. Nice to meet both you people. I was going to say guys, but I should not assume. Baron could be female, I guess. I mean, technically it should be Baroness, but I don't know, maybe you're trying to be progressive. And if I've met you before, then I apologize for not remembering. I thought guys was genderless. Yeah, I mean, people use it that way, but you know, I try to be as inclusive as possible. Turdstream is definitely a female name, yeah? Yeah, I can picture that. Man, a lot of stuff seems to be exploding for no reason in this playthrough, and I don't like it. Oh man, I wish I hadn't taken so much damage. Blood makes them explode. That's interesting. So how does everything look and sound, by the way? I spent a lot of time tweaking my FF split settings and my audio settings and all that to try to make things look and sound as good as possible without the usual experimentation that I go through. For some reason, like, every time I decide to stream, I have to check my microphone volume, because it's always set down like halfway. Looks and sounds fine. Looks good. I'm still using FFSplit, yes. I do have OBS installed, but FFSplit is just easier for me to get set up in general. My voice is a bit too powerful. Well, I can turn that down a tad. I think it's fine. Well, we'll try to compromise. Make sure you tell me if it's too quiet now. I just nudged the volume, like, a tiny little bit. Oh lord. Oh god, stay away from me. Stay away from the explosives. And another spider, great. I hope there's enough spiders in this level. Boy howdy. Mechanical Thong, welcome. Welcome. Nice to meet you. If we've met before, then your name isn't that memorable. Although Mechanical Thong is a pretty memorable name. That would be my fault if I don't remember. Aw, man, the chest is on this level. I didn't see the key. Did anyone see the key? I mean, I'm playing terribly, and I'm sure I'm not going to get the combination. I bet it's over here somewhere. Which means I'm going to have to deal with the snake and that trap. Alright. There we go. But yeah, Mechanical Thong. Aw, man, the key's not here. Probably near the Pit of Death, yeah. You're probably right. Well, I guess I can go down here and get that damsel while I'm in this area. Ah, there it is. Alright. Oh god. Damsel or key. Let's go with the key. I am probably boned. Unless the ghost comes from the right side of the screen. If that's the case, then I should be okay. And it looks like that's what happened. Excellent. Alright. Do I want to buy anything? No. Although I should have gotten that chest first. Is anyone getting the new Shadow of the Beast next year? I never played Shadow of the Beast. That was a Psygnosis game, right? That was one of the ones I never played. Although I like Psygnosis in general. I go way too fast. Yeah, me too. I definitely keep the run button held down more than I should. Alright. Springy boots. Oh god! That was a situation where I probably should have left up on the run button. Springy boots do not save you from fall damage, unfortunately. Although, ooh, that's a lot of bombs. They do make navigation a lot easier. You know what? I want to see what happens when you bomb this thing. I've never actually tried that. Is this a trap? No, it's just a lot of money. I have expected that to, like, unleash some vengeful spirit at me or something. I mean, I have all these bombs. It's good to experiment in this game. Oh god, that's a Dracula. Oh, I wasn't expecting him to wake up that quickly. Bomb it again. Okay, I'll try that next time. I want a new Altered Beast game. Well, did you play the Altered Beast game that came out for the PS2 in like 2005? Because that was pretty terrible. I actually did play that game. Hello, DJ Pandas. I wish I did. No, you don't. That game was not good. I mean, it wasn't horrible. It was just a really boring, you know, beat 'em up. It did have this really awesome animation when you turn into the beast, though. It was like the goriest thing I'd ever seen in a video game up to that point. Like, your skin melts away, and there's blood and organs and parts. Hello, Bippernesty? Bippernesty? A lot of new people. I don't know if somebody retweeted me or something, and it's bringing in a bunch of people I haven't seen yet. Or if you all just registered new usernames and didn't tell me. In which case, you know, feel free to say hi, introduce yourself. Damn it. I was hoping that would arc up and trigger that trap. Oh well, there's no way to go there. Anyway, I'd have to bomb. So yeah, I'll do a couple more practice runs and then do the daily challenge. I haven't done any of the daily challenges in like a month. I've been too wrapped up in other games. Which means I still haven't actually beaten this or finished, you know, the story in this game. Or gotten any of the secret stuff. Feel bad for having neglected it. Hey Galen, and hello Inzu Draragna. I always feel like I say your name wrong, but I butcher everybody's name, so you are in good company. Is there anything else in here? It doesn't look like it. Just call me Taz. Okay. I can remember that, probably. PS2 emulators. I've never gotten a PS2 emulator to work properly. Of course, the only game I tried was Final Fantasy X, which might not be the easiest game to emulate. I did get a PSP emulator to work really well, though, and I've been having a heck of a time going through Persona 3. Well, that didn't work out the way I planned. Yeah, that's another game that I haven't touched recently because of roguelikes. I am pretty far into Persona 3, though. I have to say, story and characters not as good as Persona 4. I'm a little disappointed, although I guess I shouldn't be. I'm so dead. I guess I shouldn't be disappointed because, I mean, you know, Persona 4, obviously, it would improve on everything that was in Persona 3. But I mean, the combat and all that stuff is still fun. It's Persona 3 portable, so I don't know how different it is from the PS2 version. But yeah, I was really surprised at how well the PSP emulator works. It's called PPSSPP, is the name of the emulator, if any of you want to try it. Not that I condone piracy, but I don't have a legitimate way to play that game. I mean, I do condone piracy, but not as a substitute for buying video games. Like, I don't support saying, I could buy this video game, but I'm going to pirate it instead. Ha ha ha. That's, not great. Oop, oh yeah, I guess that one was triggered already. Okay. But I mean, if you can't afford it, or you would buy it, but you don't have the console it's for, then, you know, go for it. I mean, don't, you know, I can't. You know what I mean. Hello, smart man. What's up? Wow, a ton of people in the chat room. I am stoked. I'm so happy to see all of you. Although, since there are so many people in the chat room, that means I can't possibly follow the conversations that are going on and play the game. But I assure you, I am reading your chats in spirit. Damn it, jump up there, you stupid, stupid man. Okay. I want to at least make it to the ice level before I try the daily challenge. I bought a number of games I originally pirated. Yeah, me too. There are a bunch of games that I pirated. I mean, when I did buy them, it was when they were on sale. But, you know, I wouldn't have paid full price for them when they came out. Stuff like the Dead Space games, I'm not really super into those games. I pirated the first one and played it, and it was okay. And then I ended up buying Dead Space 1 and 2. So, you know, they got a customer. Didn't really like Dead Space 2 that much. But I bought it, and that's the important thing. Duke, do I like XCOM? Or Duke, do you like XCOM? Kind of mixed my point of view there. I haven't played it. I own it. I bought it when it was relatively new. I paid, like, not close to full price, but closer to full price than it has been recently, and I still have not played it. I'm a little intimidated by it, to be honest. That game looks very difficult, and I do not know if I'm smart enough to play it. I do intend to play it someday, though. Not the original XCOM, the reboot. The recent reboot. I mean, I like turn-based strategy games. I'm just always intimidated by them. Although XCOM doesn't look as complicated as a lot of them. Seems like Borderlands 2 could have been a big DLC for Borderlands. I don't know. I don't really agree. Borderlands 2, not great. Added a lot of content. You know what? Screw you, Aerotrap. I'm not even... Oops. I'm going to go that way. I'm going to go this way. There. What do you think of that? Aw, man. And then I'm going to come up here and go this way. What do you think of that, spider? Some bombs will be nice. Or ropes. Ropes are cool too, I guess. Heroes of Might and Magic is the king of turn-based strategy. I like Might and Magic Clash of Heroes. Does that count? Probably not, but that's still a great game. Aw, man, there's a key there. I have all these ropes. Are you going to be okay, dog? You look like you're going to be okay. Yeah, you'll be fine. I'm going to go key hunting. I'm going to have to use my last bomb to get in there. Don't know if that's a good idea. Actually, I don't even know if I can get in there with one bomb. Maybe if I, if I do it right at this corner. Yeah, there we go. Don't know where the chest is, but hopefully it's not too obscure. Hey, hold on to that. Stop holding down the run button, Duke. Stop it. Bad Duke. Trying to drop the key. There we go. Deep breaths. Do not hold the run button. Oh, you can hold it here. Aw, man! The chest is freaking encased. I don't have any more bombs. Super. Oh well. Probably could have seen that before if I was paying attention. Well, no point in holding on to that key. Can I go down if I come over here? Yeah. That looks safer than going the direction with the spider. Oh god. I remember trying to drop an item down the one block gap in this game. Yeah, it's more difficult than it looks. They're talking some high-level video game concepts in the chat room. Hopefully I'll be able to do the chat captions on this video. Assuming that converter I've been using is still working. I haven't really focused that much on the chat captions lately because there really haven't been that many people in the chat room for the past few streams. But most of the past few streams have been Borderlands, and I feel like a lot of people weren't really that into that game, which is cool. You don't have to like everything. Okay, that's been triggered. Oh god. That man, that caveman, has not been triggered. I'm gonna look around a little bit more. I forgot the cavemen rush at you like that. Don't really know why I'm gathering all this money since I won't be able to buy the Ankh, but hopefully I'll be able to buy something. I'm lying, you have to like everything. Yes! You have to like everything I do. That's the rule. And a dark level, great. I just want to try to get through this as quickly as possible. Although I could grab this gentleman. Oh god. Oh god, that was a close one. I mean, I still got hit, but at least I didn't get eaten. Kind of ironic that I took a hit trying to, I mean, if I hadn't picked that guy up, then I would have been carrying the torch, and I probably would have been able to see what was about to hit me. Aw, man, big frog over there. Big frog. Infinite frog generator. Let's set him on fire. Oh, wait, no, that's just a candle behind him. Oh, god. Be very, very careful. Oh, I can't see anything. I don't like that. Can you kill a big frog? Yeah, you can. It just takes a while. Alright, let's do one more run. Then I will do the daily challenge, and then I will move on to Nuclear Throne. Fudge! I have a rule. If I get hit in the first 30 seconds of starting a game, I do a quick restart. Might not be honorable, but damn it. It feels right. So this will be my one more run before the daily challenge. Am I still doing Dungeon Hack after Potful Meal? Yep, that's the plan. I might do that one as a stream. If Kostya, that was just a cheap shot. I'm not going to let that happen. If Kostya would prefer it as a stream. Up to him. Could be an LP. Doesn't really matter to me. Have I tried Dungeons of Dreadmore? Yeah, I have. I don't really like it. I mean, I like roguelikes. And, you know, that's a straight up roguelike. It's not a roguelike-like. But I don't know. Something about the UI and just the way the game looks and feels rubs me the wrong way. I can't put my finger on it. It's like it always feels like the game's lagging or the game, the frame rate is bad. And I don't think it is. I think it's, I mean, I know that's a dumb reason not to play a game, but just, if I go down there, I'll have to use a rope to get back up. Yeah, not worth it. But yeah, I can't explain it. Just something about Dungeons of Dreadmore, I don't like the way it feels. Just play anything I like. Well, I mean, if you want to change your request, then, you know, I'd be happy to accommodate you. It's a game that I have. Yeah, anyone who wants to change their requests before I get to it. But I mean, I like Dungeon Hack. I'd like to play it. Play it again. Get through it. I mean, I'm not planning on doing like a super difficult run or anything. So, it won't be too painful. Alright, see you later, Perigo. Thanks for hanging out. That's a trap. I almost jumped into that trap. I'm glad I didn't. I wonder if it's actually safe to get that. I almost never get the idols in the mines. Because there's like a 90% chance that it's gonna destroy some guy's shop and the shopkeepers are all gonna be pissed off at me. But what the hell. I'm feeling brave. Oh! Ah. I'm glad the boulder didn't kill that dog. It could have been a close one. My attention span is too short for Dreadmore. Yeah, that's another thing. The levels do feel like they just take entirely too long. Maybe it was the difficulty I was playing on or something, but like, I don't know. There's not a great curve in that game. Like a curve of accomplishment. I forgot that doesn't trigger the spiders when you do that. But you know, that's just personal preference. I mean, plus, if I'm going to play a straight up roguelike, I'm probably going to play NetHack, to be honest. That's the one I've been trying to beat for like 10 years, so I don't want any of that stuff. I mean, nothing against Dreadmore. I know a lot of people like it. Hello, Pokemat28. And technically increase the frame rate in Dreadmore by speeding up gameplay. I think I tried that. I think it still wasn't, I don't know. I mean, I'm not saying it's a bad game, but, you know, it's just, it wasn't for me. Fuck that gold. I'm not fighting a scorpion for a little bit of gold. Great. There's another game I played or watched recently that had spitting snakes in it. What was that? Oh yeah, that's right. I was watching Brad play Volgar the Viking on Giant Bomb. That looks like a fun game. I want to pick that game up at some point. Oh, Red Knight 30, what's up? Been a while, yeah? Not much, man. Or woman. I've just been busy. Aw, man. I guess I could bring the chest with me and try to find the key if I didn't miss it already. See, that's been sprung. Okay. Oh, God. I'm boned. No, maybe not. If I can get the spider to stay. Ah. If I can keep the spider from sliding in through that little passage. There we go. I had to use entirely too many bombs to do that. Is that trap in sprung? Feels like it should have been, but well, yeah, one of those bombs had just triggered it, right? Yeah, okay. Because that key is right here. Need to hurry it up a little bit. Taking it a little while on this level. Use a rope to get back up there. Unlock the chest. That's been sprung. Run down here and pick up the doge. Throw the doge at a snake. Step on the other snake, get the doge, run through the door. There we go. That was a pretty successful level. Got the eye. Yeah, Doge. So rescue, much regen. Mini health. Of course, it's a pug, not a Shiba, or however you pronounce it. Shiba. But you know, I won't tell anyone if you won't. Woo! Aw, man. Get down from there. Stop being silly. I just told the internet. Told the internet what? Oh, you guys don't count. I mean, we're all cool here, right? Ah, damn it. Oh my god. And I have to use a bomb to get back up, or a rope to get back up. Great. I meant don't tell the cops. I mean, obviously I can tell you guys. Unless one of you is a cop. Are you a cop? You have to tell me if you're a cop. I saw a pretty great Twitter account right before I started the stream called Video Game Police. And it's a parody account. Making fun of all the people who complain about games not being games. Like the Stanley Parable and stuff like that. It's pretty good. I think it's just Video Game Cop, but there might be an underscore in there somewhere. You suck. I don't really know if I want those bombs badly enough to spend too much money on this. Ah, there we go. I broke even. Hey. I see a Blinky. I only have one bomb, though. I hope it's not... Oh, it's right here. Oh man, I'm not going to have enough money to buy the Ankh. Maybe I should look around a little bit first. Eh, screw it. Maybe there's some money in here. Have I ever gotten past the second world on Spelunky? Yeah, I've gotten to the boss. I mean, not the actual end game, real ending boss, but you know. I fought. What? That was not. Ugh. That wasn't even. Ugh. I might not let this one count as one of my playthroughs. God, seriously? Oh god, this is the worst possible situation. Things cannot possibly get worse than this. Holy shit, it's Perpetual Ascent. Drop bombs on them, take everything and run. Well, that's what I was trying to do. But it didn't work out. What's up, Perp? Been a while. Okay, one more, then I'll do the daily challenge. Because seriously, that was fucked. That frog was not close enough to that shop for that guy to have gotten pissed off. It didn't even damage the floor. Duke, will I post any more Isaac stuff? Probably not. I'm pretty much done with the Binding of Isaac. I got the Platinum God. I played it for like 250 hours, unlocked everything. The only thing I haven't done is all the no damage achievements. And that does not seem like a fun time. Now if that Binding of Isaac remake comes out on PC, I might give that a go. I'm not really sure what the status of that is though, or if it'll be any good. The game's not console only, is it? I don't think it is. I'm pretty sure I announced somewhere that, or I saw announced somewhere that it was coming to PC. They're remaking it already. They're like changing the art style, so it's like this pixel. It looks like, you know, fake 16-bit pixel style. And I'm not really sure if I'm a big fan of it, but I haven't really seen it in action yet, so. Oh, it is PC. Oh, they're adding a multiplayer mode? Weird. Hello, Saya-chan. Remember how long La Mulana's remake took? Well, that was because Nintendo was being a dick about it, wasn't it? I mean, wasn't it supposed to come out on the Wii, like, 3 years before it actually came out on Steam? Of course, I don't know if that was Nintendo's fault or if it was the publisher's fault. I'm sure if I jump up and hit that snake, I'm going to impale myself. I'm sure if I jump from over here, I'm going to impale myself. Or just get hit by the snake, okay. I'm still alive at least. Shopkeeper on this level? I'll risk it. Oh god! Oh, okay. I just angered God. I think it was the publisher, what Saya-chan said. Alright, let's hit up the daily challenge. And then I will get a main menu. Then I will load up some Nuclear Throne. That needs an instant replay. Yeah, it would be cool if this game had an instant replay. Actually, before I get started on this, I need to alleviate a problem. I'll be right back. Okay, problem alleviated. Play as Plant, he is my favorite. I don't know which one is Plant. Is that any of the people I've unlocked? Or is it number 10? Is it like a literal plant, or is it someone named Plant? I don't know what they would look like. I'm waiting for Mugenix. Yeah, I'm interested to see what that game is. I still have no idea what the game's actually supposed to be. I guess nobody does. Okay, well, if no one knows who Plant is, I'll just stick with the default Spelunky guy. Just, you know, for tradition's sake. Twitch has a store now. It does. What do they sell? Broken IRC clients. That seems to be a popular product. Oh, Planned and Nuclear Throne. Okay. I actually don't like the plan that much, but I'll probably show off all of the characters at least once. Oh, wait, no. Plan's pretty good, actually. He's not my go-to character, but, he's not bad. Good idea, Twitch. Don't use a pop-out window. Just interrupt the stream and load a new page. Yep, not surprising. Planned is good, except his snare breaks the camera. That hasn't happened to me yet. But that game is busted in a few ways. But I mean, it's early access, so you can't really complain about it too much, I guess. I mean, I don't know. I'm kind of conflicted about the early access stuff. It seems like a lot of games are going that route these days. And in some cases, you know, it's justifiable for, like, multiplayer games. You need people to, like, beta test it and stuff. And, you know, I guess that's a good way to do that. But in some cases, it just seems like a way to get people to buy the game before it's actually done. Which I guess is what the whole point of it is, but I don't know. It seems like a lot of people are going that route these days. I mean, whatever. People know what they're getting into when they buy it, right? So, I mean, it's not like they're deceiving anyone. Except, you know, when they say the game has features that hasn't been implemented yet. Yeah. I should probably... I mean, she's right there. It's just one rope and one bomb. And I have plenty of ropes, so why not? Early access worked out well for Minecraft, Don't Starve, and stuff like that. Yeah, that's definitely true, but... You know, those games were... I mean, I feel this way about Nuclear Throne. I don't care that I paid money for it when it's not done yet, because it's already a very playable, very functional game. And anything they add to it is just icing on the cake. Whereas there are some games I've seen on early access where it was, that was not the case. And you know, Minecraft and Don't Starve, you know, very fun, very functional right out of the gate. And then as they've been updated, they've just gotten better and better. I don't know. Kind of have to go on a case by case basis whether early access is annoying or not. I don't know how I feel about games that charge more for early access. Yeah, Nuclear Throne does that. I don't know. I mean, I'd be fine if, like, it went on sale when the early access period, or there was a sale on the game, like 15% off when the early access period ended. Like, you know, a launch sale. But yeah, just outright charging more for that. It's a little weird. I mean, I don't care. It was still only like $12, $13 or something. And it's going to be like $10 when the game is actually out, so it's not a huge difference, but I can definitely see why someone would think that's weird. Lord Tamar, welcome. Nice to see you. My bat's stuck. Good. Wow, I'm gonna have a lot of health. Knock on wood. Etc. I want to say I'm happy that Duke is streaming again. I kind of missed all of you guys. Yeah, I missed all you guys too. Been a while. Yes, it has, my friend. Yes, it has. I hate the fact that whenever anyone says it's been a while, I can't hear it without getting that stupid song in my head. If you don't know what song I'm talking about, be thankful. It is a terrible song. And I only know it because I used to watch television. And I saw the video for it multiple times. It's a very 90s phenomenon. Well, could have predicted that. It's gonna be tough getting that chest if I can actually find the key. I'm gonna have to use a bomb. Oh well. It's worth it to get the chest. Total Request Live, yes! God, when I was in high school, I don't know why, but I used to come home and watch that. Like, none of the music they played on it was anything I liked, except for Once in a Blue Moon. And of course, I don't like any of it anymore. Oh, that's a bummer. Wonder where the key was. I have a few ropes. Oh, is it in there? Yeah, I bet it's in the vertical tunnel of death. I'm not using all those resources. Sorry. I'm probably not going to make it that far anyway, so. Why did I press that button? That wasn't the right button. Not only do I impale him, I set him on fire. Yeah. I was kind of mean to that guy. Duke has a really weird music taste. I don't know if that's true. I like a lot of music. Well, okay, some of the music I like is weird, but I mean, I like pop music and stuff too. Just none of the pop music on MTV in the 90s was something I was into. Oh my. Well, I'm alive. It's a good thing I had a ton of health. I didn't think the bubble was going to get close enough to bump me like that. My ex likes Bjork. I like Bjork. I don't like all of Bjork's stuff. I really like Post, the album that had Army of Me and I Miss You. That was a really good album. I don't like all of her newer stuff, but hey, Compass, that's not bad. I should probably go after that chest. Hope I find, like, a kissing booth. Because I have a lot of money and not much health. And there's no chance of me, you know, getting the Ankh now, so no need to save up anymore. Duke has excellent taste in music. Thank you. I don't discriminate by genre. I like any music that's good. Of course, good, you know, is a pretty subjective term, but there you have it. I only have one bomb left. I probably shouldn't use it getting that pug. I don't want to get into another situation where I'm trapped. Like that one stream I did where there was a water level and I had no way of getting to the exit without a bomb. I had to swim for it and it did not work out. Stay away. It's a shotgun under this tombstone. Well, maybe that is a box, right? Yeah. Oh, it did have bombs. Great. I don't feel bad about doing this now. I mean, I do feel bad about desecrating Ash's grave. May he rest in peace, but at least I have bombs left. Shotgun is totally worth it. Yeah. I don't know. With the kickback, I usually end up killing myself with a shotgun. I should do another marathon on a game series like I did with Sonic. Well, it's not a series, but I was... Of course. I was thinking of doing a Yoshi's Island marathon on Thanksgiving. And calling it Eggsgiving. Because, you know, Thanksgiving, as Americans in the chat room know, is a holiday all about eating everything. So what better way to celebrate it than by playing a game where you eat pretty much everything? It was either that or a Kirby game. How did my torch go out? Is there water down there that I don't see or something? I guess that must be it. Or did the torch just fall farther than I can see? Oh, great. So yeah, that's not a concrete thing yet, but that is something I've been considering. I think that would be fun. Yoshi's Island is a pretty long game. It would make a pretty good marathon. And plus, I mean, it's one of my favorite games, and I've never LP'd it or streamed it. I think it's about ready to get its due. Damn it! How the hell do I get out of here? I guess I get out of here with brute force. If I did a Kirby stream, it would probably be Kirby's Adventure, since that's the only Kirby game I'm super familiar with. Oh. I stepped too close for a tiki trap. I didn't think I was that close to it, but Splatterhouse Marathon, fuck that. Shoot the gun to get more light. I didn't think of that. Quap Marathon. Yeah. That would be pretty good. Okay, I am going to switch over. I have to stop the stream because Nuclear Throne is it's a different aspect ratio. It's 4:3. So to make sure it doesn't have the annoying black bars on the side in the archive, I'm going to stop the stream and restart it. So wait about, 2 or 3 minutes, and I will be right back.